Hello, I've bought this watch recently off of eBay. I've always wanted this Casio watch and I found that skmei or skmei do their own version of it. And the version that they call it is, well, they just have a serial number 1278. This is the instruction manual for it. It's fairly sort of basic English on this side and Chinese on this side, although the English is actually a lot easier to understand than most instructions that these watches come out with. I do have a few other skmei watches. I have this Casio G-Shock sort of knockoff, which I don't really like because you can't really tell up here. There's like a line that comes across and that shows you what day it is, or you can't really see that too well. You have to press this button here to see the date, and it's just 9:29. It has some other functions, very basic ones. The light's okay on it. You can't really see that too well there. The light on this is pretty much the same sort of thing. I have this one and I have another watch. I have this one as well, which is quite a chunky watch, but the case sort of feels like it's gonna come away. It doesn't feel very secure. It's quite a big watch. The display on it's not too great. The light on there is virtually like non-existent. It almost doesn't work. It's supposed to have a compass on it as well. However, the compass is awful. I can't seem to get it to work properly. And the instructions for it are terrible as well on that one. However, this one is a much easier watch to use. This is a titanium colour. And on the picture, it seemed a darker grey than this. You can get different colour ones like black, blue, red, green. And I think there are some that do a slightly different colour wrist strap as well. And this watch is based on a Casio, a serial number of 2499 or 3092. I'm not too sure exactly. And it's supposed to have a 10-year battery life. I'm not too sure about this one. Obviously, it says things like 50 meters water resistant on the back. It says five atmospheres there. So I'm not too sure how accurate that is. I haven't tested it yet. I'm a little bit sort of skeptical because this took about a month to receive it. I was kind of impatient about it. I think I paid £5. I think you can get it slightly cheaper. But I wanted one with a silver casing. The light on this one stays on for about 3 seconds. It does work quite nicely in the dark. I mean, it's smaller than what I thought it would be. And I'm used to something slightly larger like this G-Shock type or the calculator style watches. It's fairly comfortable. The strap itself is kind of flimsy. It feels like it might tear or it might break. This feels kind of flimsy. So it has the keys here, A, B, C, D. It goes round anti-clockwise. Pressing the mode button will go through the, will cycle through the functions. C button, and it will go from 12 hour to 24 hour. To set the time and date, press and hold A, this button, for 2 seconds. It starts flashing. Press the C button to cycle through. And then press this button to adjust. Then when you're done, just press the adjust button again. Press the mode button to get to alarm. Press the D button. And there you'll see it will count through the alarms. So while in alarm mode 1, pressing button C will set the alarm 1, and then a snooze function, SNZ. So when in alarm mode, if you press button D to get to this option and then press C, you see the signal or SIG comes off. If you push that on, you'll get an hourly chime, which is basically just a beep beep sound. So to change the alarm, so I'm going to set the first alarm. Press and hold A for 2 seconds. And then it's B and C, cycles through the hours. Press and hold, see what that does. There you go. And to enter the chronograph mode, go to stopwatch. Button C will start and stop. Press button A to reset. So when it's running, you press button A and it goes to split. Press A again and it stops. So I think that's two times that you can record. So the watch will keep running. In countdown setting, press and hold A for 2 seconds. And B or C will change the hour or the minutes. D changes the hours. A will come out of that. So it's set to 1 minute at the moment. So that's now counting down. To go into the dual time, again, you can set two times for this. So the time at the moment is 10 to 2. Hold this for 2 seconds and you can adjust the time. The D button, press and hold and it'll go through it quickly. And that's the watch. Thanks very much. Subscribe and like. Thank you.